Tyler Hajar helps his dad change a headlight on his truck. An ordinary task that is extraordinary when you consider where Tyler was when we first met him 5 years ago.
I'm fighting kind of inside. When I wake up every day, I sit there and I go, why can't you just get up, get up, get up? I pray to God sometimes to the point where I'm in tears. Just get up, just get up, just get up.
This was Tyler 10 years into his struggle with depression. He had exhausted his treatment options and lived daily with thoughts of suicide.
Kiss is allowed. Kiss is welcome.
We'll be checking updates in during the day. Great. We're doing this, you know, we're doing that. Yeah. It's a long day.
Tyler became the 38th person at Emory to undergo deep brain stimulation surgery for depression.
I love you, buddy.
I love you too, Dad.
You're gonna be fine. This is gonna work.
Tell her family I said I love you. Okay?
Dr. Helen Mayberg is a pioneer in the field. And for Tyler's surgery, collaborated with neurosurgeon Robert Gross.
Right side, lateral.
And psychiatrist Patricio Riva-Posse, the director of Emory's treatment-resistant depression clinic.
Each lead has 4 contacts per hemisphere.
Tyler was part of a study that we did here at Emory in which we were implanting a new experimental battery that not only delivered stimulation, but allowed us to record the brain signal from the lead that is in the brain, in the subcolossal cingulate, in each hemisphere.
The cameras captured when the contact connected in a precise spot in Tyler's brain, a life-altering moment.
Even before he said the name, I felt lighter. I felt physically lighter. I mean, just all over, shoulders, neck, head. Back, I mean, just everything felt lighter.
Is it a good feeling?
Yeah.
How easy would it be to actually get yourself out of bed?
Seems like it'd be a lot easier.
So how is your anxiety right now?
I don't feel it.
Okay, rate the heaviness 0 to 7.
Give it a 1.
Okay, rate the anxiety 0 to 7.
I call it a 1. Now it's just kind of gratefulness, like a lot of gratefulness.
So feelings feel more real?
Yeah.
So with how you're feeling right now, is this the best you've been during our time here?
I'd say so.
I remember looking at them and feeling the way I felt. It was that weight off the shoulders, just like, Wow. I haven't felt like this. I can't remember the last time I felt like this. It was amazing.
That felt like we had our son back at that moment. And when I watch it, I always get emotional. When I get to that part, and I'm not, you can hear me choking a little bit right now, I get emotional because, you know, you want the best for your kids. And the worst thing I think as a parent is to see your child suffer.
So I'm gonna ask you to put this over your battery.
After this surgery, brain activity started being recorded, and a month later, stimulation began. This protocol included 9 other patients. What was discovered in these recordings is groundbreaking. Using artificial intelligence to interpret these brain recordings, a neural code emerged, showing how neural activity changed between a state of depression and of wellness. It's a biomarker, a measurable indicator of disease that gives clinicians a tool similar to a blood glucose test for diabetes. It's a readout of the disease state at any given time. And something else, what was happening in the brain tracked what researchers saw when interviewing the patients in a clinical setting. Simply put, the inside matched the outside. The team's research also confirmed the long-standing observation by psychiatrists that as patients' brains change and their depression eases, their facial expressions also change. The team's AI tools identified patterns in individual facial expressions from weekly recorded interviews that corresponded with the transition from a state of illness to stable recovery.
We also did structured interviews each time that the patient came, and the signal of the brain also tracks with the changes in the patient's face.
I'm well.
So if we can have a very strong correlation between the brain and the face, we might be able to then just use facial data to tell us how the patient's brain is doing.
These patterns proved more reliable than current clinical rating scales and could eventually have broad use in the field. The study was published in the journal Nature in 2023. After 6 months of DBS therapy, 9 of the 10 patients showed significant improvement in their depression, and 7 no longer met the criteria for depression. One of those 7 is Tyler.
I mean, comparatively to what it was like in 2019 to now, it's night and day.
The house is filled with photos of Tyler since surgery, smiling, out of the house, at family events.
I can get up in the morning, and I look forward to getting up in the morning. And I work part-time at a drug and alcohol rehab facility. So I get to hang with the guys and cheer them up, be goofy a little bit. Things I used to do a lot.
The biggest change is this.
You haven't had a suicidal thought since surgery.
That is accurate.
That's the miracle.
It's my favorite question to answer. When I'm doing those scales, because they have to ask, you know, have you had any suicidal thoughts or ideations or any plans? And I go, no. And every time I do it, I kind of get a little smile on my face. Not because it's like, you know, it's a funny subject, but because I'm like happy. I'm so grateful.
He's one of 50 people in America that has this gift.
But that number will now grow. One of the DBS manufacturing companies not involved in Tyler's surgery has obtained a breakthrough designation from the FDA, and a new multi-site clinical trial will be launched at the end of 2024. This surgical treatment could one day be a real possibility for some of the 3 million people who suffer from treatment-resistant depression. There are no more days in bed. There are days helping dad find the right tool to change a headlight. And there are still times when they are overwhelmed remembering all they've been through in order to get here.
Don't give up before the miracle happens. I was ready to do that, and I am so grateful to, you know, God and my, you know, my family, my parents, my friends that supported me and helped me hang on for one more day. You never know what the next day is going to bring. One day I'm sitting there going, the end is near, goodbye cruel world type stuff, and then the next I'm getting a call about this radical surgery that could save my life. And at that point I was willing to do anything. And I waited, and it came true. My miracle came true. This is my miracle. I'd hate for someone else to lose out on that opportunity. So just, if anything, just one more day. That's what he told me for years. He'd come into my room, check on me, and he'd say, Tyler, proud of you, buddy. We're gonna get this taken care of. We're gonna get you fixed. We're gonna get this fixed. Just hang in there one more day. Just for the rest of the day, just one more day. I did that one more day for years. And, you know, it worked.